Hi friends, in our last video we have seen what is Docker volume. So in this video we will look what is Docker Compose and why Docker Compose is required. Okay, so what is Docker Compose? See, let me show you two scenario. In the earlier what we have seen, that if I want to create a container, if I want to run a container, then I used to run the Docker images. Okay, but suppose I have a scenario that if I want to run multiple container from a single image at a time, in a single command I want such a option that I could run multiple containers. Suppose I want to run 10 container of Nginx at a time, how can I run? So with the manual process before, what we have to do, suppose I have Docker images. So I have Nginx image. Suppose I want to run 10 Nginx container. So what should I do? Right now I have an option that I should run this Nginx image 10 times. So that I will get 10 containers. Suppose my company requirement is there, they want 100 Nginx container. Then I have to run this Nginx image 100 times. So this is not a good practice. So what is the, is there any option, is there that if I want to run multiple containers from a single image, then is it possible? Yeah, it is possible. And suppose in second scenario, what is there that if I want to run multiple container from the multiple images, suppose I want to run 10 Nginx images, 20 Tomcat images, like this I have a requirement. So what I have to do, I have to go manually and I have to run this images. So this will be the time consuming. So what the option is there, what is the alternative? So we have the alternative of Docker Compose. So with the Docker Compose, what we can do, we can write a YAML script inside that and we can run as many as a container, or we can run multiple container as well from a single, within a single time. So what Docker Compose is, now we got that these two scenario can be helped with the Docker Compose. But actually what Docker Compose is, see, Docker Compose is a third party utility. This is not installed by default with the Docker engine. Whenever we install the Docker engine, Docker Swarm is one concept which we will discuss later. That is the orchestration tool. But Docker Swarm is installed by default. But Docker Compose doesn't install by default. Means what I mean to say that Docker Compose is not a part of the Docker. It is a third party tool which has been acquired by Docker. Okay, so to use the Docker Compose in our Docker engine, we have to install the Docker Compose individually. So we will see how to install the Docker Compose, but before that let me explain you how Docker Compose works. So Docker Compose uses the YAML format. What is YAML format? See, YAML format is just similar to the which we have seen many JSON file is there, or XML file. Likewise, only YAML is also a syntax. Means in YAML we uses the module, and with the module we writes the syntax. So those who already have worked in the Ansible or Kubernetes, they might be aware of YAML, what actually YAML is. I will discuss YAML in depth in a separate video. So I am not going to touch YAML in this video, because YAML itself is a different topic. So as of now, just understand that Docker Compose uses YAML language, YAML syntax. With the YAML syntax, we can write Docker Compose file. Okay. So that is what the YAML is. And see, with the Docker file, and we have one more important thing you need to remember. Many people, what they confuse is that Docker file and Docker Compose are same. No, obviously not. Docker file we use is to create Docker image. We can create Docker image from the Docker file, but we can't create Docker container from the Docker file. And Docker Compose is used to create Docker container. Both are separate, both are different things. Docker file is used to create the Docker images, while Docker Compose is used to create the Docker container. Okay, so you got why we use Docker Compose, because we can create multiple container from a single image, or we can create multiple container from multiple images as well, which we will show now, which we will see now in the practical session. Okay, so and before that we have to install the Docker Compose, as Docker Compose is not present in our system by default. Suppose if I will run Docker Compose --version, then what error I am getting? The Docker Compose is not present in your system by default. Docker Compose command not found. So we have to install the Docker Compose. So I had already mentioned all the steps how can you install Docker Compose, and you can go to this official website of also Docker, from where you can install Docker Compose. Already I have opened Docker Compose website. See, this is the website of Docker Compose. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to come downside in this install Compose. You are getting multiple operating system options, like Windows is there, Linux is there, Mac is there. So as I am going to install on top of the Linux, so I will select Linux from here, and now I will select the command. See, what is the command? Actually, what they did, they have just uploaded their script in the GitHub. So I am just pulling the script from GitHub, from their Docker GitHub account, and I will run that. So by default my Compose will be installed. So just I have to copy and paste that command. After that Compose will be downloaded. See, now Compose is installed in my system. But before that, let me change the file permission as well. I have given execute permission to this Compose file. If I will go to this bin directory, I will be able to see that Compose file will be there. See, Docker Compose file already came here. So this is what we did. So if now I will give the command Docker Compose --version. See, this time I am not getting the error like command not found. This time I am getting the Docker Compose version. So by this way we have installed Docker Compose in our server. Okay, now the thing is, how can we run Docker Compose and how to write the Docker Compose? Okay, so already I have written Docker Compose YAML file. So if you want to get the same YAML file, you can go to my GitHub account. Already I have mentioned my GitHub account. You can go to this GitHub account, github.com.devopsg1. Inside that I have made a Docker folder. In the Docker folder you will be able to get all the files I have already uploaded over there. Okay, so you can pull it from there. So that is my public account, so you can pull it here, pull it from there, no issue is there. So see, now let me open one of the, I will explain you only one YAML file, that how we used to write the YAML file. So let me open. See, I have opened this. See, in the YAML syntax, those person who are aware of the YAML syntax, that is good, but those who are not aware, let me explain them that YAML follows the indentation rule. Indentation, what is indentation? Actually indentation what says, that gap should be similar. See, I have actually, what is this inside this, what I am doing, these all are the modules. Version is the module, service is different module. Okay, so inside this module what I am given, I am creating two image. This name I can give by any name I can give. This web name or web server, whatever name you want to give, you can give any name by your choice. So inside this services, this will create a web name, means inside this it will create an image with the name web, and this will be the app. So I have choose two images. Okay, so the image name I am taking the Nginx. Suppose I am installing the Nginx image and I am installing the Tomcat image as well. So I want the container for this Nginx and Tomcat. I want the container for these two, Nginx and Tomcat. Okay, and these all are the functionalities which you can add. Like we know, we had already seen that for any Nginx application, port 80 should be there. Port 80 should be exposed. Okay, so that's why we have mentioned ports 80. Volume also we have given. All these are optional. Volume is optional, but however I am showing you with the volume option as well. Or and more options you can give. Whatever the functionalities you want to add in the Nginx server, you can add there as well. So this is in simple word what I want to say, that in the YAML syntax you have to just follow the gap. See, two spaces are there, 1, 2. So all these image name whatever I will mention, that should be of same layer. See, web and app is starting with the same space. Okay, app is also having only two space in the beginning. Now if you, this is just similar to the loop. In programming language we follows the loop, and in YAML syntax it is just similar to the loop, that now web is web, inside the web what is the image, ports, volume we are getting, this is the nested loop. We can compare it with the nested loop, that this is the loop, this web will, this image, ports and volumes is coming inside the web. Okay, this is same with the app also. So when once you will learn the YAML syntax, you will be able to understand this syntax which we have written over here. This is very simple. YAML is very simple to understand, and I will make a separate video for when I will come up with the lecture of Ansible. Ansible uses the YAML syntax only, YAML as well as JSON, but we used to write in YAML language, as YAML is very easy to understand and it is human readable. So I have just created this Docker Compose file. So now I have to run the Docker Compose. Okay, so see what is the command to run the Docker Compose. Already we have installed the Docker Compose as we have seen earlier. Now see what is the command. See, I have shown few scenario over here. For Docker Compose hyphen f is the file name, which file you want to run you have to give, and up. What the up means? Up means you have to bring up this container, you have to run the container. If you will give down instead of up, then you have to shut down the container, you have to shut down the running container. Okay, so up means to bring up the container, and down means to stop the container. So I am using up, and hyphen hyphen scale. With the hyphen hyphen scale, see, if you remember, inside the compose file we have used two module, web and app. So we have given the web equal to 2, app equal to 3. But see, the main important thing what the most people face, does the commit the error, what is that once they uses the scale, I have used hyphen hyphen scale web equal to 2. So see what error I am getting, no such services app equal to 3. Means the command is send me that app equal to 3, no such services we are able to find, because you are not giving hyphen hyphen scale. If you will give hyphen hyphen scale, then what Docker Compose will understand, that one module exists with the name of the web inside this compose file, and we have to run this module. But as I haven't used the hyphen hyphen scale, so what it will do, it is giving me that no services is found. So in such scenario, see, if I have removed this app 3, then I am already able to run this script. Okay, run this YAML file. So in this scenario what is happening, see, I have mentioned two module is there, web and app. Web is identifying the Nginx and app is identifying the Tomcat. But when I ran the web only, see, only Nginx is coming up, only Nginx will come up, not Tomcat will come up, because we haven't used the app. But see, in the second scenario I have used the app as well. When I used the app equal to hyphen hyphen scale app equal to 3, so see in this scenario what is happening, two web server and the 3 app. So in the web what is the Nginx image is there, and in the app Tomcat image is there. So see what is happening, web 1 web 2 web server came up, web is having the Nginx image, and 2, 3 Tomcat came up, 1, 2, 3. 3 Tomcat are there. So you can easily see that when we have given the number of count, the same it is coming up. You will understand it in a better way when we will do the practical. So no need to worry if you are not getting my point. So see, here I have shown the command also to bring down the container. Instead of up, I have used the down command. Okay, so you can go through this document which I have prepared. So now let us do the practical. So what command we have seen, Docker compose, and after the Docker compose we have to give the file name. See, I want to run this file name, okay? So I have given this one. Now we have to give the up command. I want to bring up the server. So after this I will give a scale. Two hyphens should be there, remember. With the scale, two hyphen will be there. What should be the name? Web. Web is the name. Again, I want to scale app. I want to scale. Sorry. See, what mistake I am committing. Scale web. What is the web count? I want to bring up two web server, and inside the web Nginx server, Nginx image is there, and I want to bring three app or suppose one app. So one Tomcat server will come up. Okay. So this is the command which we have to run. So see what is happening now. First it is pulling the Tomcat image. After the Tomcat image, again it will pull the Nginx image, and we will get three containers. Two is for the Nginx and one is for the Tomcat. So let us see what is happening. So let this command to finish. So see, as you are able to see, three containers is up. Already we got three containers. One is for the Tomcat. Why one is for the Tomcat? Because we have given app equal to one. And as we remember that in the cat compose YAML file, app signifies to Tomcat server. So only one Tomcat server is, one Tomcat container is coming up. And two Nginx container is coming up. Why two Nginx? Because we have given web equal to 2 and web module signifies to the Nginx image. Okay. So, 2 Nginx container came up. Got it? Now, see. I want to suppose I require only one Nginx server. I don't want 2 Nginx. I don't want 2 Nginx container. So, we have two options. Either I can use the down command to move it, to reduce the count. Or I can, what I can do, I can give the new count as well. Suppose I want to reduce one, but currently two Nginx container is there. So what I will do, instead of two from the web, I will reduce it to one. If now I will run this command, see what changes will happen. Docker ps. Now what you are looking that, now only one Nginx container is there. Previously two Nginx container was there, but when I reduced the count with the one, so what happened, they have removed one Nginx container, and we are able to see one Nginx container is present. Okay. So this is what the, suppose I want to remove all these container. So what is the command? Docker compose -f file name. So compose YAML my file name. I will simply give down. I will do nothing. I will give down. Now see, Docker ps. No command is there. No container is there. All the containers has been removed, which was mentioned inside this compose file. Okay. So when I will run this compose file, so it will bring down all the containers which was created with this compose file. Okay. Got it. So I think you got the concept of what is Docker compose and all. I have few more command. I have written few more script for YAML file for this Docker compose. If you want to do the practical of this as well, you can go to my GitHub account and you can download it from there. I have uploaded all the YAML in my GitHub account. So see what where it I am going. I am just running only one container here, that is Nginx. But see, multiple options here I am using. Here I am using ports along with restart. We have already seen that what is the use of restart. We have already this network mode we haven't seen. In the upcoming videos we will see what is the network mode and how many types of network mode is there. So what I mean to say that we can use multiple options inside our Docker compose. Whatever the significance I want to give to the Nginx container, everything I can assign over here. So see, here I am creating two volumes. So this Nginx will be having two volumes. This path will be the mirror image for this path, and this temp directory path will be the mirror image for this path. So this is what I did. So you can do the practical for this. I had already uploaded all these YAML file to my GitHub account. So you can pull it from there and you can run in your system. So I think we are clear with the Docker Compose. And if you want to do the practical, if you want to get this document from of Docker Compose, you can download it from my Facebook group. In Facebook group, I uploaded this Docker Compose with the name of DevOps G. One DevOps G group is there in my Facebook. So you can go to the Facebook and you can download the document from there. I will upload all the documents, all the notes, all the material over there. So you can download it from there. So I think it is, now you are clear with the Docker Compose. So I am binding up the session. I think you are confident with the Docker Compose. So in the next session, we will come up with the Docker network. Now we are left only with the two main important parts of the Docker. The one is the Docker network and the other is the Docker Swarm. So we will understand these two concepts for this Docker, and apart from these two concepts, 80% of the Docker portion is over. Okay. So I think now you have to do your practical, and please do the practical parallelly, because without practical you are not going to understand anything. So this is sufficient for this video. Bye bye. Take care.